We take water for granted. Ben Franklin was right. You learn the value of water when the well runs dry. And human behavior has replicated that time after time after time. I was general manager of the Water Authority from its inception in 1991 until I retired in 2014. I was general manager of the Water District, and I was the governor's chief negotiator on the Colorado River. Every single Monday morning, we had a senior staff meeting. My head of engineering and operations walked in and she said, "Pat, we've got a huge problem. The snowpack in the upper Colorado is so bad, we are not going to get even 30% of normal runoff. The reservoirs are going to crash. We're not going to be able to take additional water out of Lake Mead. And Arizona puts us on notice. They can't bank for us." All the dominoes started falling. Between Mead and Powell, you have over 50 million acre feet in storage when they're full. So to have them both going down to quarter capacity is a pretty scary proposition. The loss of water in that reservoir system has been enormous. Go look at the bathtub rings. They're scary. Lake Mead is full at sea level elevation 1220. Today, it is down around 1080. 5 more feet, and Lake Mead goes into shortages. And all of us take a haircut. We build this huge tunnel underneath Lake Mead so that we can access even the last drop should the worst of all possible scenarios happen. We began to implement a whole series of measures aimed at driving down residential use. We banned grass in the front yards. We put in water waste ordinances. We put the community on a watering schedule. We even put covenants on the property. The entire Las Vegas Strip, with the fountains and 40 million tourists a year that come through, as their net water footprint, they use 3 to 4% of all the water. So everything that's used inside in those hotels is captured, treated, and reused, either indirectly or directly. We all recognize and identify ourselves as citizens of a community. And we identify ourselves as citizens of a state. And we identify ourselves as citizens of a nation. We never identify ourselves as citizens of a watershed. Water is a basic human right because you need it in order to live. But what you don't have a basic human right to is that that water is pumped from great depths in Lake Mead, treated to a very safe standard, and then pumped 2,500 feet to your front door to where all you have to do is turn on the tap. That infrastructure costs money. So in your capacity as a human being, if you believe it's a basic human right, take your bucket, go to Lake Mead, knock yourself out. Take as much as you want. If you want it treated and delivered at your house on a guaranteed 24/7 basis, then you have an obligation to help defray those infrastructure and operating costs. The impact of climate change is going to play itself out in the water arena. And to simply turn your head and say, it's not going to affect us, is insanity.
The same amount of uranium pellets in an advanced reactor can power 800 houses for a year.
And the computers that we're using now, they've changed to where we've got real-time tracking, real-time data. We can see our procedures, we can see our limits real-time instead of having to wait to see the data later.